4000 BC. Indus Valley in India was an advanced civilization with knowledge of engineering and architecture. 7th century BC, Takshashila in India was the world's first university with over 10,500 students from all over the then known world studying in over 60 subjects. Indians invented the zero, and they were also at the origins of the algorithms, the system used throughout the world today for computing. 21st century AD, Indian Institute of Technologies in India, a world-class institution for higher technological education and research in India.
I recall seeing a leading American television program where the anchor was interviewing a group of applicants for admission in the IITs. He asked, "What will you do if you do not make it?" The answer left me stunned and proud. "We will then apply to MIT or Caltech."
IIT Madras, inaugurated in 1959, has come a long way since the past 50 years and celebrating its golden jubilee. 250 hectares of a Garden of Eden, in the heart of Chennai in India. A perfect working environment for the best minds of the 21st century. An educational institution dedicated to science and engineering, where students and research scholars work abreast with the future technology of the world. Life at IIT Madras is one of the most memorable one for its students.
I really like studying here in IIT because we have such a nice campus.
A brilliant student community, filtered and selected by the toughest of entrance examinations. A faculty of international repute, working in close association with the leading industries and research centers the world over. Excellent technical and supporting staff and an effective administration all have contributed to the preeminent status of the institute. A German aid of nearly 50 million Deutsche Marks has made it the largest aided German project in the world.
The IIT Madras is not just one of the leading technical universities in India. I think it has become the pride of Tamil Nadu. It has become the pride of India. It has become one of the main reasons why, for example, you would find also so many German investments here in Tamil Nadu. And it has really become the pride of Germany.
Courses offered at IIT Madras are BTech, MTech, MS, and PhD programs in as many as 16 disciplines. Harnessing new technologies for a vision of tomorrow is the IIT on one side and the ever-competing industries on the other. Bringing both together and bonding them in an everlasting relationship is the Center for Industrial Consultancy and Sponsored Research. We at IIT Madras were the first to set an example for closer interaction between an academic institution and the industries since the beginning in 1973. In this space age of the 21st century, we are competing with the developed countries for a niche in the exploration of outer space. The contribution of IIT Madras is quite significant in space exploration and in development of missiles and other technology for the defense forces. Biomedical engineering, fluid mechanics, and solid mechanics are the three major divisions in the Department of Applied Mechanics. It has excellent facilities to carry out theoretical and experimental research. Research on development of smart materials for the future is underway. The focus of study in the Department of Biotechnology is in areas like cancer biology, genetics, vascular biology, computational biophysics, neurosciences, etc. The Department of Chemistry has many laboratories under inorganic and analytical chemistry, organic and bio-organic chemistry, physical and interfacial chemistry. A new molecule is being discovered every minute, and the focus of research in the Department of Chemistry at IIT Madras is on research on fuel cells, molecular computing and quantum computing, magnetic resonance imaging, harnessing solar energy through polymer optical fibers, and many more. The Department of Chemical Engineering has many laboratories in addition to computational facility. Some of them are Particle Science Laboratory, Biochemical Laboratory, Transport and Reactions Laboratory, Polymer Engineering and Process Control Laboratory. Students are encouraged to participate in co-curricular interdepartmental activities, like for instance at IIT's Center for Innovation.
We had two students from Chemical Engineering Department who have designed and built the first Formula EC IITM car.
The five functional divisions of the Department of Civil Engineering are Building Technology and Construction Management, Environmental and Water Resources Engineering, Geotechnical Engineering, Structural Engineering and Transportation Engineering. All five divisions are on the cutting edge of technology. The faculty members have excellent interaction with the industries. The department was started in 1973 with the acquisition of an IBM 370, which was perhaps the most powerful computer of those times. The Department of Computer Sciences and Engineering is in the forefront of the information age that is propelling Indians towards global leadership. The Department of Electrical Engineering integrates the activities in the areas of electrical, electronics and communication engineering. Computer-aided design laboratory, with its powerful workstations and animation softwares, provides a platform for the creativity of the students to learn design techniques for future designing at the Department of Engineering Design. Mechatronics and Control Laboratory, Automotive Research Laboratory, Underwater Research Laboratory, Air Brake Laboratory, Vehicle Dynamics Laboratory are some of the laboratories here. The Department of Humanities and Social Sciences offers MA in English, Economics and Development Studies. The vision of the Department of Management Studies is to be globally unique for source of knowledge, creativity and expertise in management. A number of MOUs have been signed with many reputed universities the world over, enabling our faculty and students to pursue research under exchange programs in return for hosting faculty and students from other universities abroad. The Department of Mechanical Engineering is the largest, spread over an area of 10,000 square meters. The machine design section consists of the latest design workstations and tools. Center for Non-Destructive Evaluation undertakes a number of research and consultancy projects and has patented several technologies. The Manufacturing Engineering section has state-of-the-art machine tools and metrology laboratory equipped with top-of-the-line CNC machining center, automated assembly stations and industrial robots, micro-machining center, sheet metal research station, and contact and non-contact coordinate measuring machines. The Precision Engineering and Instrumentation Laboratory focuses on precision gears and robotics. Thermal Sciences and Engineering Division consists of Heat Transfer and Thermal Power Laboratory, Hydro Turbo Machines Laboratory, Internal Combustion Engines Laboratory, Refrigeration and Air Conditioning Laboratory, Thermal Turbo Machines Laboratory, Thermodynamics and Combustion Engineering Laboratory. Four major areas of teaching, research and consultancy activity in the Department of Materials and Metallurgical Engineering are Materials Technology, Metal Forming, Metal Joining and Metal Casting and Process Modeling. The Department of Ocean Engineering is in a unique position to carry out model tests under three-dimensional wave conditions similar to deep sea wave heights of the order of 20 to 30 meters. It has a laboratory area of 3,000 square meters with a wave basin 30 meters by 30 meters and 3 meters deep. In addition to this, a towing tank and many other flumes are also available. The focus of study here is in X-ray crystallography, semiconductor physics, solid-state physics, and spectroscopy, with emphasis on nuclear and magnetic resonance spectroscopy. With the addition of a full-fledged low-temperature laboratory, study is on in superconductivity, magnetism, thin film phenomena, and so on. The study of chaos in the tiniest bits of matter to the harmony in the furthest reaches of the cosmos, all are of much interest to our theoretical physicists. We are in the midst of an unknown space, somewhere between the unknown macrocosm of the cosmos with its infinite number of galaxies and the unknown microcosm of the smallest strings. Nature does not reveal her secrets once and for all. Many discoveries are reserved for the ages still to come. Research will continue in our laboratories in pursuit of knowledge.